In mathematics, a Hopf algebra, named after Heinz Hopf, is a structure that is simultaneously an algebra and a coalgebra, with these structures' compatibility making it a bialgebra, and that moreover is equipped with an anti-automorphism satisfying a certain property. The representation theory of a Hopf algebra is particularly nice, since the existence of compatible comultiplication, countite, and antipode allows for the construction of tensor products of representations, trivial representations, and dual representations. Hopf algebras occur naturally in algebraic topology, where they originated and are related to the H-space concept, in group scheme theory, in group theory, and in numerous other places, making them probably the most familiar type of bialgebra. Hopf algebras are also studied in their own right, with much work on specific classes of examples on the one hand and classification problems on the other. Theorem: let A be a finite-dimensional, graded commutative, graded co-commutative Hopf algebra over a field of characteristic zero. Then A is a free exterior algebra with generators of odd degree. Formal definition. Formally, a Hopf algebra is a bialgebra H over a field K together with a K-linear map S, HH such that the following diagram commutes. Here delta is the comultiplication of the bialgebra, its multiplication, eta its unit and epsilon its countite. In the sumless Swedley notation, this property can also be expressed as for algebras. One can replace the underlying field K with a commutative ring R in the above definition. The definition of Hopf algebra is self-dual, so if one can define a dual of H, then it is automatically a Hopf algebra. The symmetry of the above diagram is the same as a pseudo-scalar meson. Properties of the antipode. The antipode S is sometimes required to have a K-linear inverse, which is automatic in the finite-dimensional case, or if H is commutative or co-commutative. In general, S is an anti-homomorphism, so S2 is a homomorphism, which is therefore an automorphism if S was invertible. If S2 equals IDH, then the Hopf algebra is said to be involutive. If H is finite-dimensional semi-simple over a field of characteristic zero, commutative, or co-commutative, then it is involutive. If a bialgebra B admits an antipode S, then S is unique. The antipode is an analog to the inversion map on a group that sends G to G-1. Hopf subalgebras. A subalgebra A of a Hopf algebra H is a Hopf subalgebra if it is a subcoalgebra of H and the antipode S maps A into A. In other words, a Hopf subalgebra A is a Hopf algebra in its own right when the multiplication, comultiplication, countite and antipode of H is restricted to A. The Nichols-Zola-Freeness theorem established that the natural A module H is free of finite rank if H is finite dimensional, a generalization of Lagrange's theorem for subgroups. As a corollary of this and integral theory, a Hopf subalgebra of a semi-simple finite-dimensional Hopf algebra is automatically semi-simple. A Hopf subalgebra A is said to be right normal in a Hopf algebra H if it satisfies the condition of stability, ADRA for all H in H, where the right adjoint mapping ADR is defined by ADR equals S, R for all R in A, H in H. Similarly, a Hopf subalgebra A is left normal in H if it is stable under the left adjoint mapping defined by ADL equals HAS. The two conditions of normality are equivalent if the antipode S is bijective, in which case A is said to be a normal Hopf subalgebra. A normal Hopf subalgebra A in H satisfies the condition HA plus equals A plus H, where A plus denotes the kernel of the countite on K. This normality condition implies that HA plus is a Hopf ideal of H. As a consequence, one has a quotient Hopf algebra H, HA plus an epimorphism HH, A plus H. A theory analogous to that of normal subgroups and quotient groups in group theory. Hopf-orders A. Hopf-order O over an integral domain R with field of fractions K is an order in a Hopf algebra H over K, which is closed under the algebra and coalgebra operations. In particular, the comultiplication delta maps O to OO. Group-like element. Say group-like element is an element X such that delta equals XX. The group-like elements form a group with inverse given by the antipode. A primitive element X satisfies delta equals X1 plus 1X. Representation theory. Let A be a Hopf algebra, and let M and N be A modules. Then, Mn is also an A module, with for Mm, Nn and delta equals. Furthermore, we can define the trivial representation as the base field K with for Mk. Finally, the dual representation of A can be defined. If M is an A module and M asterisk is its dual space, then where Fm asterisk and Mm, the relationship between delta, epsilon, and S ensure that certain natural homomorphisms of vector spaces are indeed homomorphisms of A modules. For instance, the natural isomorphisms of vector spaces MMK and MKM are also isomorphisms of A modules. Also, the map of vector spaces M*MK with FMF is also a homomorphism of A modules. However, the map MM*K is not necessarily a homomorphism of A modules. Examples. Note that functions on a finite group can be identified with the group ring. Though these are more naturally thought of as dual, the group ring consists of finite sums of elements, and thus pairs with functions on the group by evaluating the function on the summed elements. Cohomology of Lie groups. The cohomology algebra of a Lie group is a Hopf algebra. The multiplication is provided by the cup product, and the comultiplication by the group multiplication G times GG. This observation was actually a source of the notion of Hopf algebra. Using this structure, Hopf proved a structure or theorem for the cohomology algebra of Lie groups. Theorem. Let A be a finite dimensional, graded commutative, graded co-commutative Hopf algebra over a field of characteristic zero. Then A is a free exterior algebra with generators of odd degree, quantum groups and non-commutative geometry. All examples above are either commutative or co-commutative equals YX. Other interesting Hopf algebras are certain deformations, or quantizations, of those from example 3, which are neither commutative nor co-commutative. These Hopf algebras are often called quantum groups, a term that is so far only loosely defined. They are important in non-commutative geometry, the idea being the following. A standard algebraic group is well described by its standard Hopf algebra of regular functions. We can then think of the deformed version of this Hopf algebra as describing a certain non-standard or quantized algebraic group. While there does not seem to be a direct way to define or manipulate these non-standard objects, one can still work with their Hopf algebras. And indeed one identifies them with their Hopf algebras. Hence the name quantum group. Related concepts. Graded Hopf algebras are often used in algebraic topology. They are the natural algebraic structure on the direct sum of all homology or cohomology groups of an H space. Locally compact quantum groups generalize Hopf algebras and carry a topology. The algebra of all continuous functions on a Lie group is a locally compact quantum group. Quasi-Hopf algebras are generalizations of Hopf algebras, where co-associativity only holds up to a twist. They have been used in the study of the Nijnik Zamolodchik of equations. Multiplier Hopf algebras introduced by Alphonse van Daler in 1994 are generalizations of Hopf algebras where comultiplication from an algebra to the multiplier algebra of tensor product algebra of the algebra with itself. Hopf group algebras introduced by V.G. Turayev in 2000 are also generalizations of Hopf algebras. Weak Hopf algebras. Weak Hopf algebras, or quantum groupoids, are generalizations of Hopf algebras. Like Hopf algebras, weak Hopf algebras form a self-dual class of algebras, i.e., if H is a Hopf algebra, so is H asterisk. The dual space of linear forms on H. A weak Hopf algebra H is usually taken to be a finite-dimensional algebra and coalgebra with coproduct delta HHH and countite epsilon HK satisfying all the axioms of Hopf algebra except possibly delta 1-1 or epsilon 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 for some A, B and H. Instead one requires the following. For all A, B, and C in H, H has a weakened antipode S, HH satisfying the axioms. For all are in H or epsilon S with image a separable subalgebra denoted by HR or H's. For all are in H or epsilon T with image a separable algebra HL or HT, anti-isomorphic to HL via S. For all are in H. Note that if delta equals 1-1, these conditions reduce to the two usual conditions on the antipode of a Hopf algebra. The axioms are partly chosen so that the category of H modules is a rigid monoidal category. The unit H module is the separable algebra HL mentioned above. For example, a finite groupoid algebra is a weak Hopf algebra. In particular, the groupoid algebra on N, with one pair of invertible arrows EIJ and a he between I and J in N, is isomorphic to the algebra H of NXN matrices. The weak Hopf algebra structure on this particular H is given by coproduct delta equals EIJ EIJ, countite epsilon equals 1 and antipode S equals a he. The separable subalgebras HL and HR coincide in a non-central commutative algebras in this particular case. Early theoretical contributions to weak Hopf algebras are to be found in as well as Hopf algebroids. See Hopf algebroid analogy with groups. Groups can be axiomatized by the same diagrams as a Hopf algebra, where G is taken to be a set instead of a module. In this case, the field K is replaced by the one-point set. There is a natural countite. There is a natural commultiplication. The unit is the identity element of the group. The multiplication is the multiplication in the group. The antipode is the inverse. In this philosophy, a group can be thought of as a Hopf algebra over the field with one element. In numerous other places, making them probably the most familiar type of bialgebra, Hopf algebras are also studied in their own right. With much work on specific classes of examples on the one hand and classification problems on the other, theorem let A be a finite-dimensional, graded commutative, graded co-commutative Hopf algebra over a field of characteristic zero, then A is a free exterior algebra with generators of odd degree. Formal definitions, trivial representations, and dual representations. Hopf algebras occur naturally in algebraic topology, where they originated and are related to the H-space concept, in group scheme theory, in group theory, and is satisfying a certain property. The representation theory of a Hopf algebra is particularly nice, since the existence of compatible commultiplication, countite, and antipode allows for the construction of tensor products of representation. In mathematics, a Hopf algebra, named after Heinz Hopf, is a structure that is simultaneously an algebra and a coalgebra, with these structures compatibility making it a bialgebra, and that moreover is equipped with an anti-automorphism.